Hello everyone, welcome to Sunya IS and welcome to this lecture. In this lecture, we are going to cover a very important period of our ancient history, which is the Mauryan Empire. This is the very empire which became the first empire of India. So you understand the difference between a dynasty and an empire is that empire is on a much larger scale and has an impact which goes beyond its time period, right? So even today, we see the impact of Ashoka the Great in the form of our emblem, in the form of the various pillar remains that have been left by Ashoka, and of course, in the form of Buddhism being spread to various other countries. Then we see the impact of Chandragupta Maurya, how by the spread of Jainism in South India, right? Chandragupta Maurya took Jainism to South India. Then we see the impact of Chandragupta Maurya in the works of Kautilya, right? In the form of Arthashastra. So what is an empire overall, which has an impact, which transgresses its own time period and it's on a much larger scale with much more powerful rulers. That is an empire. So Mauryan Empire was the first empire of India, okay? Rest of the empires and rest of the dynasties that we have read till now, they were dynasties. This is empire. Now, the time period of Mauryas is 324 to 187 BCE. And when we are in the BCE period, we count backwards. So 324 is older than 187 BCE. And 324 is the year when Chandragupta Maurya formed the Mauryan Empire. So with this, let's start with the Mauryan Empire. There have been plethora of questions every year from Mauryan Empire. So that is going to be there. Now, before starting, this is something about our course which we are running, which is revised entire prelim syllabus through 3000 plus MCQs. We have already done polity. We have done economy, modern history, geography, and environment and ecology. Now we are on ancient medieval. Then we'll do art and culture, science and tech, current affairs. So this is the whole plan. And the course we have made, if you go for it, you will be able to get the PDFs before getting into the lecture. Solve the questions, read the answers, and if you still have any doubt, only then come to the classes. Okay? So that will save you a lot of time. So you can contact on this number, visit this website. Okay. Before starting, just see that how wide the Mauryan Empire was. In fact, Mauryan Empire was the first truly pan-India empire in India. Pan-India means which covered entire India, right? And you see the southernmost part of India. This is something that most of the rulers have not been able to assimilate in their empire. Because this is the area, the Cheras, the Cholas and the Pandyas, that formed the Sangam age. And Sangam age in itself was a civilization of its own. So even today, you know, in India, we have this north-south divide kind of a thing. The culture of South India is very different from North India, which is completely fine. Okay? We are in a modern nation state. But historically also, Mauryan Empire was not able to totally take over the area of Sangam age, and it restricted itself to this Brahmagiri range basically. And Brahmagiri, if you remember our geography lessons, Brahmagiri range is the range from where Kaveri river starts, right? Tal Kaveri Brahmagiri. So this is the extent. So till Kaveri river, there was direct rule of the Mauryas. Then see here, in the westernmost part, till Kandahar, we have seen that how rock edicts and pillar edicts of Ashoka have been found. Then Shahbazgari, that is in the Jammu Kashmir side and in the, you know, northernmost side of India, basically touching the Himalayas, we have been seeing the Mauryan Empire. And here, till the eastern part of India, going beyond Bangladesh, we have seen the Mauryan Empire. So how geography determines the empires also, you will see that because we have the Himalayas over here, the Mauryan Empire could not stretch beyond the Himalayas because that kind of technology was not there. And even today you see that this is the Tibetan plateau, right? This is the Tibetan plateau, and this is India. The culture of Tibetan plateau and India is just so different. You see Nepal over here, you see UP and Bihar over here, and you see Tibetan plateau over here. Just so much difference in culture because of geography, right? So this is Mauryan Empire at about 250 BCE, 250 BCE, middle of Mauryan Empire, I would say. And yes, have a broad idea of this, and then with this, let's start the lecture. Consider the following statements regarding Mauryan administration. Mauryan administration was highly decentralized. It was managed by a systematic and highly organized bureaucracy. Which of the given statements are correct? So Mauryan administration is just a successor of Mahajanpats, right? Mahajanpats mein se the most powerful Mahajanpat became Magad. And Mauryas were the rulers of Magad. Who were the rulers of Magad just before the Mauryas? The rulers of Magad were Nandas, right? The Nand dynasty, Nandas dynasty. And the last ruler, that is Dhanananda. Dhanananda was defeated by Chandragupta Maurya. And in 324 BCE, Chandragupta Maurya established the Mauryan Empire in Magad. So you see how important this role of king is. The role of king is extremely important in the Mauryan administration, and that is why the Mauryan administration was not decentralized. In fact, it was highly centralized. Okay, on the contrary, it was highly centralized administration, and that's what Kautilya in Arthashastra also told the king, that don't trust anyone, right? Do not give a lot of power to anyone. Do not give a lot of how would I say trust to anyone. Because you have to believe in real politics. So when you get selected and you go to Labasna, Arthashastra is taught even there. Hai na? The beginning of bureaucracy, the beginning of diplomacy, the beginning of real politics in India starts with Arthashastra. So very interesting things. But overall, Mauryan administration was not decentralized. Mauryan administration was centralized. But it does not mean that the king performed every duty that was to be performed. Mauryan administration, why we still admire it? Because it had a very strong bureaucracy. The network of bureaucracy that it created was just phenomenal. Every task had an officer to perform that task, and every officer was accountable to some other officer. So that means there were multiple checks that were there. So there was very less scope of corruption. So that is there. So two is the correct answer. Two only is the correct answer. But one is not correct. Mauryan administration was centralized. So have a look at the important kings. In fact, all the kings that were there in Mauryan Empire. So you will see Chandragupta Maurya, 320 through 322 slash 324. Both the years are relevant. ठीक है? 322 भी बोला जाता है, 324 भी बोला जाता है. And he ruled for a very long period of time. More than 20 years he ruled. He ruled till 298 BCE. Then came Bindusar. Bindusar was also a important ruler. Do not confuse him with Bimbisar. Bimbisar is from Haryanka dynasty. Bindusar is from the Mauryan dynasty. And Bindusar is the father of Ashoka the Great. ठीक है? And these kind of questions can be asked wherein match the following will be given. Only one, only two pair will be given. There was this question that was asked on Nag Sen and Nag Arjun. That who was involved in the writing of Milinda Panho, right? So that was Nag Sen, not Nag Arjun. Similarly, it is Bindusar, not Bimbisar. Then there is Ashoka the Great, 273 to 232 BCE. Then there is, so these three were important rulers. Then there is Dashrath, Samprati, Salisuka, Devvarman, Satadhanvan, and Brihadrath. Brihadrath was a weak ruler, as you can see, ruled just for 2 years, and he was killed by one of his deputies called Pushyamitra Sunga. ठीक है? So after the Mauryan Empire, the Sunga dynasty came into picture, and the Mauryan Empire became the Mauryan Empire only during these three kings. Otherwise, it was a dynasty only because rest of the kings were not that powerful. So this is there. Okay, next question. Consider the following statements regarding Mauryan administration. Rajukas were in charge of the district and correspond to the district magistrate of the present day. Samaharth is the chief treasurer, while Sannidhata is the collector general of revenue. And the provinces were divided into districts called Janpats. How many of the given statements are correct? So you want to be a district magistrate, right? So if you were in the Mauryan period, you would have been wanting to be a Rajuka. Rajuka was a ruler of a district, the manager of a district, basically accountable to the king, of course. But first statement is absolutely correct. Now, second, it has been reversed. Samaharth was basically collector. Today, in some places you call district magistrate, and in some places you also call it as district collector, right? Why? Because earlier, during the British times, the task of a collector and a magistrate, that is the revenue functions and the judicial functions, both were performed by the same system, same person, right? And that is why district magistrate slash district collector. But at that point of time, just think how advanced the Mauryan Empire was, that there were different people. So Rajuka was a district magistrate. He took care of the law and order. And Samaharth was the district collector who would collect the revenue out of the peasants and everything. And Sannidhata is the one who will keep the money safe. So treasurer, ठीक है, treasurer, the money that is being collected, that is being kept safe by the Sannidhata. So see, that is what I mean when I say that highly differentiated bureaucracy, highly specialized bureaucracy, but not a decentralized bureaucracy. ठीक है, centralized yet a very efficient one. In fact, there was a very strong system of spies also that was just that used to exist at that point of time. So second is incorrect because Samaharth is the collector, Sannidhata is the treasurer. Third, provinces were divided into districts called Janpats. This is absolutely correct. Janpat was the area where the masses used to live. ठीक है, जनपद वॉज द एरिया वेर मासेस यूज टू लिव. एंड जस्ट लाइक वी टूडे स्टेट्स इन टू डिस्ट्रिक्ट, सिमिलरली द प्रोविंसेज ऑफ दैट पीरियड वर डिवाइडेड इन टू जनपद, दैट वर डिस्ट्रिक्ट ओनली. सो हियर ओनली टू स्टेटमेंट्स आर करेक्ट. यू हैव बीन एबल टू सी फोर टर्म्स ओवर हियर, राजुका, समाहर्थ, सन्निधाता एंड जनपद. ठीक है, चलो नेक्स्ट. कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स. अशोक वादन इज अ पाली टेक्स्ट दैट क्रॉनिकल्स द रेन ऑफ एम्परर अशोक. द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ सुदर्शन लेक बिगैन ड्यूरिंग द रेन ऑफ चंद्रगुप्त मौर्य. एंड विशाखा दत्ता मुद्र रक्षक एस्टैब्लिशेस चंद्रगुप्ता कनेक्शन विथ जैनिज्म. हाउ मेनी ऑफ द गिवन स्टेटमेंट्स आर करेक्ट? सो लेट्स गो वन बाय वन. अशोक वादन, द टर्म इटसेल्फ is having the word Ashok in it. So Ashok Vadan definitely was a text, but it was not a Pali text. Okay, it was a Sanskrit text. It was a Sanskrit text, and it saw that how Emperor Ashok used to reign. So first is incorrect because it was not a Pali text. Fine. Then second one. Construction of Sudarshan Lake begins during the reign of Chandragupta. This is absolutely correct. Sudarshan Lake is in Gujarat. Okay. And this Sudarshan Lake has a very important historical value because it was created by during the reign of Chandragupta. Then it was damaged multiple times, and then it was repaired also later on by a ruler called Rudradaman. He was a Shaka ruler, but it was repaired by Rudradaman. So गुजरात में है, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लेक. आई विल शो यू द लेक लेटर ऑन ऑल्सो. सो सेकेंड वन इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. थर्ड वन, विशाखा दत्ता मुद्र रक्षक हैज बीन आस्क्ड मेनी टाइम्स. एंड दिस विशाखा दत्ता मुद्र रक्षक, विशाखा दत्ता वॉज अ कोर्ट राइटर ऑफ चंद्रगुप्त मौर्य. एंड मुद्र रक्षक, सॉरी, ही वॉज द कोर्ट राइटर ऑफ गुप्ता डायनेस्टी. ठीक है, Gupta dynasty later on. Chandragupta the second. Yes, he was later on. And Vishakhadatta's Mudra Rakshak was the work which showed the people how Kautilya groomed Chandragupta Maurya as the king of Magadha to protect India. So if you were to ask, you know, if you tomorrow go into interview and you are asked that, you know, in ancient India, tell me the name of any nationalist that you know. Kautilya or Chanakya is the biggest nationalist that was there at that point of time, because he could foresee that Alexander is about to attack us, and that is why we need to come together as one unit. So very important personality. And in Vishakhadatta's Mudra Rakshak, it has been established how Kautilya groomed Chandragupta Maurya. So this is incorrect, because Chandragupta's connection with Jainism have been given in another work, which is also a very important work, which is Parishta Parvan. Parishta Parvan. And this is given in NCERT only. Parishta Parvan, and it was written by Hemchandra. Hemchandra. Do not confuse it with Hemu, who fought with Akbar in the Second Battle of Panipat. Do not confuse it with him. Hemchandra is the one who wrote Parishta Parvan. And Parishta Parvan has the connections of Chandragupta with Jainism. He was, of course, influenced. Chandragupta was influenced by Bhadrabahu, and he went to Shravan Belagola along with a lot of followers, and eventually Digambar was born and Shvetambar was separated. So third is incorrect. So now you know that only one here is the correct answer. But you know about Ashokvadan, you know about Sudarshan Lake, you know about Mudra Rakshak, and you know about this Parishta Parvan. ठीक है, चार चीजें एक क्वेश्चन से पता चल गई हैं. नेक्स्ट, दिस इज हाउ इन वन क्वेश्चन यू आर आस्क्ड मल्टीपल फैक्ट्स बाय यूपीएससी. सो आई ऑलवेज से इट्स नॉट दैट यू आर बीइंग गिवन 100 क्वेश्चंस, इट्स मोर लाइक यू आर बीइंग गिवन 250 क्वेश्चंस के आसपास, बिकॉज एवरी अदर क्वेश्चन विल हैव 3 to 4, समटाइम्स 5 स्टेटमेंट्स ऑल्सो. फाइन. So, paper is getting very difficult, paper is getting more and more complex, and that is why these kind of questions we are also creating. Consider the following statements. Satvahans granted tax-free villages only to the Brahmins. The earliest epigraphic grant of land is found in the Nasik inscription of Naganika, and these villages were under the complete control of Satvahan kingdom. Which of the given statements is or are correct? So here you see that Satvahans, first of all, in Mauryan Empire, why is the question on Satvahan being asked? Satvahans immediately followed the Ashoka's reign. So when Ashoka was there, many works during Ashoka have mentioned as the Satvahans as Andhra Putra. Andhra Putra. ठीक है, एंड व्हेन अशोका पास्ड अवे, दैट वाज द टाइम दैट दिस सातवाहन डायनेस्टी व्हिच वाज अ मैट्रिलिनियल डायनेस्टी स्टार्टेड टेकिंग शेप. ओके, सो हियर यू मस्ट नो दैट सातवाहन्स दे वर अ ब्राह्मण किंगडम, एंड इनफैक्ट दे वर नॉट वेरी इम्प्रेस्ड विद द मौर्यन किंगडम. व्हाई? बिकॉज एंड दे रूल्ड इन द डेक्कन एरिया, इन द सेंट्रल डेक्कन एरिया, नॉट इन द छोटा नागपुर प्लेट्यू, जस्ट बिलो द छोटा नागपुर प्लेट्यू. सो Why were they not impressed? They were not impressed because according to the Varna system, who is supposed to rule? The Brahmins are supposed to rule, right? So, the Mauryas were not Brahmins, right? The origin of Mauryas is not very much known. Chandragupta Maurya, some say he was a Kshatriya. Most people say he was a Kshatriya. Some say it's not known what his caste was. So, Satvahan was a purely Brahmanical kingdom that way. And Satvahans granted tax-free villages to Brahmins. This is correct. But only to Brahmins is incorrect. They also granted tax-free villages to Buddhists. ठीक है, Buddhist monks. So, Buddhist monks को भी tax-free villages देते थे. First incorrect हो गया, Satvahan dynasty. And second is absolutely correct. There is this Nasik inscription, very famous inscription. एंड इट इज रिटन बाय नागानिका. नागानिका वॉज द वाइफ ऑफ अ रूलर कॉल्ड सतकर्णी. वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द सातवाहन्स. सतकर्णी की वाइफ थी एंड दिस इज वेयर शी रोट दैट वी आर गिविंग लैंड लैंड ग्रांट टू द बुद्धिस्ट मॉन्क्स. ठीक है, सो सेकेंड इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. दिस इज द अर्लिएस्ट एपिग्राफिक रिकॉर्ड ऑफ ग्रांटिंग लैंड टू बुद्धिस्ट मॉन्क्स, नॉट टू ब्राह्मण मॉन्क्स, टू बुद्धिस्ट मॉन्क्स. द थर्ड, दीज विलेजेस वर अंडर द कंप्लीट कंट्रोल ऑफ सातवाहन किंगडम. दीज विलेजेस दैट वर बींग गिवन टू द ब्राह्मण्स और द बुद्धिस्ट मॉन्क्स वर कंप्लीट कंप्लीटली अंडर कंट्रोल ऑफ सातवाहन किंगडम. नो, एज एंड वेन मोर एंड मोर लैंड केप्ट ऑन बींग गिवन टू द अदर पीपल, द लैंड बिकेम अ कमोडिटी, है ना, एंड दैट इज द टाइम वेन फ्यूडलिज्म स्टार्टेड. ठीक है, सो नाउ लेट्स से दिस इज द लैंड ऑफ एंटायर किंगडम एंड स्मॉल एरियाज आर बींग गिवन टू सम और द अदर बुद्धिस्ट मॉन्क्स. सो दीज स्मॉल एरियाज, बुद्धिस्ट मॉन्क्स और ब्राह्मण मॉन्क्स, दीज एरियाज आर नाउ बींग रूल्ड एज इंडिपेंडेंट किंगडम्स, राइट, स्मॉल इंडिपेंडेंट किंगडम्स हु आर जस्ट पेइंग लिप सर्विस टू द सातवाहन्स. बट अदरवाइज द सेंट्रलाइजेशन दैट वॉज सीन ड्यूरिंग द मौर्यास वॉज नॉट सीन ड्यूरिंग द सातवाहन्स. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ठीक है, सो यहाँ पे थर्ड गलत हो गया. Only one statement is correct, that is the second one. When we study Satvahans, we will be studying about the Nasik inscription, है ना, Nasik inscription, Nani Ghat inscription भी बोलते हैं. We'll be studying about that. Next. Okay, consider the following statements. Kakini were the commonly used coins during the Mauryan Empire. Charak was the court physician of Kanishk and is considered the father of surgery in India. And coin legends during the reign of Satvahans were inscribed in Sanskrit. So, how many of the given statements are correct? Along with the Mauryan Empire, there are questions on post-Mauryas as well. Okay? So, first, see, Kakini was not the name of the coin that was used during the Mauryan Empire. But the name of that coin is very important. The name of that coin is Karashpan, Karashpan or Karashpan. Karashpan. How will you remember this? Pan. Pana. Pana means a small token of money, right? So, Karashpan was the coin that was used and there were no words written in it, right? Today, we have coins which have the denomination written on them and various symbols made on them. But Karashpan did not have any words written on them. Just some punched mark coins. So, first is incorrect. Kakini was not the name. Then Charak. Charak was the court physician of Kanishk. Kanishk from Kushan dynasty, who is post Mauryan dynasty. So that much is correct. That Charak was the court physician of Kanishk. But Charak is not the one who is called the father of surgery in India. It is actually Sushrut. It is Sushrut Samhit who is called the father of surgery in India. And Sushrut wrote the Sushrut Samhit, under which various surgical processes have been mentioned. ठीक है, so he is Sushrut का जो time period है that is not exactly known, but he wrote the Sushrut Samhit and that is the origin of surgery in India. So Charak was the court physician of Kanishk, but Charak wrote Charak Samhit and Charak Samhit is more about the medicinal properties, right? Herbal medicine, Ayurveda. So it is more about Ayurveda. And Sushrut Samhit is more about the surgery. So second is incorrect. Third, coin legends during the reign of Satvahans were inscribed in Sanskrit. So though Satvahan was a very Brahmanical kind of a dynasty, they still learnt this much from Ashok that you need to adopt the language of the common people to make them understand you. So they inscribed their coins in Prakrit. Prakrit. And another very important thing about the Satvahans is that they adopted lead coins. Lead coins. Okay? Very important. Lead coins adopt kiye the unhone. Right? So if you are asked that which was the dynasty which used lead coins extensively, it was the Satvahans. Fine. So here, none is the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Match the following pairs with reference to the capitals of provinces in Mauryan Empire. Uttarpath Takshila, Dakshinpath Suvarnagiri, Eastern India Tosali, Avantirath Ujjain and Kalinga, Tasli or Dholi. How many of the given statements are correct? So as and when Mauryan Empire grew, there was not one Pataliputra was not enough to, you know, take the do this governance in a proper manner. And that is why Mauryan Empire was so successful, because they knew that you need to diversify your power centers also. What if you are attacked in one power center? So they had five capitals for their whole expanse of the kingdom. And this area, you can see, these are the capitals of Magad. So let's just point the capitals on Magad of overall the Mauryan Empire. See, there is Kalinga. Okay, there is Kalinga. And Kalinga ka yudh sabko pata hai, that what happened when Ashok fought the Kalinga war. He was overcome with grief, overcome with sadness. He left violence and whatnot, although he did not leave violence as such. He did not leave the policy of war. He did not disband the army. But anyway, so here is Kalinga, and Kalinga is the province, the capital of which is Dholi. And you must have heard about the Dholi elephant. It has been asked earlier in UPSC examination. So Dholi is the capital of Kalinga. Then here you have Pataliputra. Okay. Here you have Pataliputra, and in Uttarpath, you go from Pataliputra. You know, I traced the Uttarpath and Dakshinpath in the last class for you. So Uttarpath goes towards this direction. And here in Gandhar, because the extent of Mauryan Empire went till here, Uttarpath's capital is Takshila. Okay, so Takshila became the capital of Uttarpath. So here is Kalinga, then there is Uttarpath. Then come to Dakshinpath. Dakshinpath will come from here, and this is the path that Chandragupta Maurya traced when he went to South India. There is Suvarnagiri over here. Okay, and this Suvarnagiri is the capital of the Deccan part of Mauryan Empire. Do not confuse it with Shravanbelgola. Shravanbelgola is also in Karnataka, but Shravanbelgola is the area where Chandragupta Maurya went with his followers and established the, along with Bhadrabahu, he established the overall the Digambar sect. Fine. But Suvarnagiri is different. That's the southernmost capital. So after Suvarnagiri, there is another capital called Tosali. Tosali is just above this Kalinga, hai na? Just above Dholi, there is Tosali. Fine. And then there is Ujjain. If you remember, when we traced the Mahajanpats, we did trace Avanti over here, right? And Avanti's capital was Ujjain. So Western India was seen up by Ujjain. So which are the five capitals? Let's erase this Pataliputra and Gandhar, otherwise you'll be confused. Pataliputra, of course, was a capital. But overall, the five places which were important provinces for the Mauryas, their capitals, what were they? So you come to the southernmost area, the Dakshinpath capital is Suvarnagiri. You come to the northernmost area, that is the Uttarpath, the capital is Takshila. Then you go to Eastern India, the capital is Toshali. Then you go to just downwards from Eastern India, that's Kalinga. And why two separate capitals so closely? Because Kalinga was a very important province. Hena, Kalinga was a very important province for Ashok. And that's why a separate capital over here. So the capital was Dholi. And in the middle of India, in the central India, there is Ujjain, that is the capital of Avanti. Avanti Rath. So five provinces, five capitals, and primary capital is Pataliputra. That is something that we know. Chalo ji, next pe chalte hain. With reference to Mauryan administration, acha, so yahan pe paancho sahi marked hai. Okay, paancho hi sahi marked hai. All five are correctly matched. Next, With reference to Mauryan administration, consider the following statements. There is a mention of female personal bodyguards of the king. Itijika Mahamata were ministers in charge of women welfare. Sanchar were wandering spies, whereas Sanstha were stationary spies. And Pativedak and Pulisani were special reporters to know the public sentiments. How many of the given statements are correct? These are some important terms and terminologies. So let's just see. All the four statements here are correct. So there was a question regarding the Vijayanagar Empire, which we will also cover, that there were female athletes, female wrestlers that were there. Then females used to be involved in accounting and all that. So on that basis, we have tried to dig in that what was the role of females in Mauryan Empire, right? So yes, there is a mention of female personal bodyguards of the king, and this mention is in the book none other than Arthashastra. Arthashastra में ही ये mention किया गया है. And because there was a question on Arthashastra as well, that you know, what if a king has a son with someone who is not his wife, etc. etc., female slave and whatnot. So इस तरीके के questions because पूछे जाते हैं, they are asked, that is why we are covering. Second one is also correct. इतिजिका महामत्ता. महामत्ता ओवरऑल मींस ऑफिशियल, हाई ऑफिशियल. सो इतिजिका महामत्ता वर मिनिस्टर्स हु वर इन चार्ज ऑफ विमेन वेलफेयर. दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. देन सांचार वाज वर वॉन्डरिंग स्पाइस. सी सांचार वर्ड इन इट सेल्फ टूडे मीन्स ब्रॉडकास्टिंग, है ना, सांचार करते हैं. तो सांचार वर द वॉन्डरिंग स्पाइस, एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. एंड संस्था, संस्था क्या होती है इन हिंदी? संस्था मीन समथिंग दैट इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड. सो संस्था वर द स्टेशनरी स्पाइस, इवन दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. एंड पतिवेदक, दिस हैज बीन आस्क्ड अर्लियर. पतिवेदक एंड पुलिसानी, दे वर स्पेशल रिपोर्टर्स टू नो द पब्लिक सेंटिमेंट्स. दे वर नॉट स्पाइस, बट दे वर द पीपल हु वुड गो इन टू द मासेस एंड कलेक्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन फॉर द किंग. जस्ट लाइक यू नो, वी हैव बिफोर इलेक्शंस, वी हैव पीपल अपॉइंटेड बाय पोलिटिकल पार्टीज हु आर ट्राइंग टू नो वॉट इज द पब्लिक सेंटिमेंट, यू नो. सिमिलरली एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम देर वर पतिवेदक्स एंड पुलिसानी. सो हियर ऑल फोर आर करेक्ट. एंड यू नो हाउ मेनी टर्म्स फ्रॉम हियर? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 टर्म्स यू नो. सो प्लीज कीप मेकिंग अ नोट. इफ यू डू नॉट हैव द सॉल्व पीडीएफ, यू कीप मेकिंग अ नोट. इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट टू रिवाइज देम. नेक्स्ट, कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग पेयर्स. बिंबिसार, घटोत्कच, अशोक एंड देवभूति. सो द रूलर नेम इज गिवन एंड डायनेस्टी नेम इज गिवन. शुंगा डायनेस्टी, मौर्यन डायनेस्टी, गुप्ता डायनेस्टी एंड हरियंका डायनेस्टी. दिस इज एग्जैक्टली द काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन विच कैन कम अप. बट दिस इज स्टिल एन इजियर फॉर्म ऑफ दैट क्वेश्चन, आई वुड से. वाई? बिकॉज मैच द फॉलोइंग विल स्टिल हेल्प यू टू अराइव एट द करेक्ट आंसर समहाउ. बट I want that you should not be needing match the following itself. You should not be looking at the options only. Just see, Bimbisar, the first ruler of Haryanka dynasty. Bindusar, the second ruler of Mauryan dynasty, father of Ashok. Okay, then there is Ashoka the Great, we know, Mauryan Empire. Then we are left with Ghatotkach and Devbhuti. So Devbhuti is actually a part of your Sunga dynasty. Devbhuti is a part of Sunga dynasty. Ghatotkach is one of the, I would say, weaker rulers of the Gupta dynasty. He would come when we study the Gupta dynasty. Ghatotkach ka mention aayega, right? So this is how you match it. So one would be with D, two would be with C, three would be with B, and four would be with A. So D is the correct answer. Okay, next question. Consider the following statements with respect to king in Mauryan dynasty. Greek writers address him as Amitrochetes, that is destroyer of foes. Mahabhashya refer to him as Amitraghat, that is killer of enemies. He conquered the land between the two seas, that is Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal. And according to Strabo, Antiochus, who was a Syrian king, sent Demichus as an ambassador to his court. Whom do these descriptions in the above statement refer to? Chandragupta Maurya, Bindusar, Ashok, or Gautami Putra Satakarni? So in this case, you know, when so many details are there, still you are not able to arrive, you need to cancel out, right? You know a lot of things about Chandragupta Maurya and Ashoka, and never have these terms come into the picture. Amitra Shades, Amitra Ghat, never used for Chandragupta Maurya and Ashoka. So you cancel out Chandragupta Maurya and Ashok. Now, out of Gautami Putra Satakarni and Bindusar, Bindusar was a very brutal ruler, right? Bindusar was a very brutal ruler, and he was someone who was rightly called as the destroyer of foes because he mercilessly killed his foes. So he had two-pronged strategy for his foes. One was that he would kill them, and the second was that he would go into a matrimonial alliance with them. So Bindusar is not given enough credit for it, but he was a very major reason why Mauryan Empire was able to stretch itself so much. So Bindusar is the correct answer over here. Next, consider the following texts: Indica Arthashastra, Divyavadan, Ashokavadan, Mahavamsa Deepvams, Parishta Parvan, and Digha Nikaya. How many of the following literary sources provide information to us about the Mauryan Empire? So it would be a heartening feeling for you that you now know most of these works, right? These are eight works that are given, and all eight tell us something about the Mauryan Empire. Now it's important to know who wrote which work. So Indica was written by Megasthenes. Megasthenes, Greek ambassador. Arthashastra, we all know, written by Kautilya. Kautilya is also known as Vishnugupta, okay? And it is also said that Arthashastra was not actually written by one person, it was written by multiple people, but that research has not, fructified yet, so we are just going with Kautilya or Vishnugupta or Chanakya. Then Divyadan and Ashokavadan, these two are written by multiple authors, so there's no one author that you can give. Then Mahavamsa and Deepvams are about the spreading of Buddhism in the Indian subcontinent and especially in Ceylon, that is Sri Lanka, right? So Mahavamsa was written by Mahanama. Mahavamsa was written by Mahanama. दीपवंश किसने लिखी थी? इट्स नॉट क्लियर. सो दीपवंश का देयर इज नो राइटर. देन देयर इज परिष्ट परवान. आई हैव जस्ट टोल्ड यू हु रोट परिष्ट परवान, सो टेल मी इन द कमेंट्स. आई कंपेयर्ड इट विद राजा हेमू, रिमेम्बर सेकेंड बैटल ऑफ पानीपत. सो टेल मी इन द कमेंट्स हु रोट परिष्ट परवान. दीघ निकाया, दीघ निकाया इज अगेन अ बुद्धिस्ट टेक्स्ट. इट हैज मेंशंस ऑन द मौर्यन एम्पायर. फाइन. So all these eight works are important, and now you know something about what each of them had. Next, consider the following statements. Chandragupta Maurya was a contemporary of Alexander the Great. Stationary and roving are two types of spies mentioned in Arthashastra. Mahamatas were responsible for judicial administration in the cities of the Ashokan regime. How many of the given statements are correct? If you get this kind of a question, consider yourself lucky. Fine, because this is a very easy question. You know that Chandragupta Maurya fought with Dhanananda and took over the Magadhan Empire, right? So yes, he was actually a contemporary of Alexander the Great. However, Alexander the Great died before being able to cross Indus, and Chandragupta Maurya and Alexander never actually got into a fight. So being contemporary does not mean coming in contact with each other. Being a contemporary means existing in the same time frame. So just like Buddha and Vardhman Mahavir, they never came into contact with each other. There is no record of both of them coming in contact of each other, but they were still contemporaries. So similarly, Chandragupta Maurya and Alexander the Great, both of them were existing in the same point. But was Ashoka and Alexander the Great existing at the same point? No. Alexander was dead by the time Ashok took over. Okay? So that is there. Stationary and roving are two troops. I already told you this is correct. And Mahamatas were responsible for judicial administration. Yes, Mahamata in itself is a position, a strong official. So C, all three are correct. Next. Consider the following statements. Buddhism for the first time went outside India during the reign of Bindusar. Just a second. Then Ashok appointed Dharma Mahamat to propagate Dharma among various social groups, including women. And Third Buddhist Council at Pataliputra was organized after the death of Ashok. So, how many are correctly given? So, one you should be clearly able to eliminate because we did the Buddhist councils in the last class, and I told you everything related to it is important. So, 250 BC mein Third Buddhist Council happened, 483, 383, 250, remember? And Third Buddhist Council was headed by Ashoka itself, like happened under the patronage of Ashoka. And who was the saint that was there? It was Mogliputta Tissa. Remember? Mogliputta Tissa. So please do not keep forgetting previous classes as we go to the next classes because there are some static facts that are always important. So third is incorrect. Third Buddhist Council happened when Ashok was alive. And Buddhism for the first time went outside India during the reign of Bindusar? No. It went outside India during the reign of Ashok. Of course, it went during the reign of Ashok because Ashok sent his own son and daughter, his son named Rahul and his daughter named Sangamitra. He sent both of them as Dharma Mahamat and Dhamma Mahamat to propagate Dhamma among the various social groups, including women. And here Dharma is written, but the exact word is Dhamma. Theek hai? Dhamma. So definitely it was during the reign of Ashoka. So first is incorrect, second is correct, and only one is the correct answer. Just like you know, we have missionaries in Christianity. So similarly, there were Dhamma Mahamatas who were going beyond the borders of India of that point of time to spread the knowledge about Buddhism and Dhamma. Okay. So here one only is the correct answer. And one very basic question that people do incorrectly is that which is the school of Buddhism that that Ashoka propagated? Which is the school of Buddhism? Is it Hinayana or Mahayana? It is Hinayana because Mahayana Buddhism was not even born till the time Ashok was there. It was born under Kanishk. We'll study about Kanishk later. But basics कभी भी wrong नहीं करने. Which of the following statements is or are correct? The edicts of Ashok are primarily written in Pali and Sanskrit languages. The coins of Mauryan Empire had symbols like crescent on arches, tree in railing, etc. So select the correct statement. So here you should know that Ashok used the language of common people. And the language of common people was Pali, but the language was never Sanskrit. Language of common people was never Sanskrit. And the purpose of Ashokan edicts, you know, if this is an Ashokan edict, the purpose was to interact with the people. You know, today we have social media. Earlier there was no social media, right? So politicians could not tweet. Who was Ashoka? Ashoka was a politician. All these rulers were politicians, right? So they used to erect these edicts, ठीक है, rock edicts, and they used to write their messages. And the messages to be understood to people have to be in simple language. So they were in Pali and Prakrit, not in Sanskrit. So first is incorrect, second is correct that their coins did not have any words on them, but coins did have some symbols on them. So second is correct. Which coins did they use? Punch mark coins. Fine. Punch mark coin is when the metal is wet, so you just smash it with a stamp, a punch kind of a thing. So a shape develops on the coin. That is punch mark coin. Okay. Next. Consider the following statements. Minor and major rock edicts were largely confined to the Ganges plains. edicts were widely distributed throughout the Ashokan Empire, and some of Ashokan edicts described the medical treatment of humans and animals. How many of the given statements are correct? There are two kinds of edicts. There are minor and major rock edicts, and there are pillar edicts. So the rock edicts, just think about it, the rock edicts are easier to make, right? So the rock edicts will be available throughout the empire, but the pillar edicts wherein there is a monolithic pillar. You understand what is a monolithic pillar? That this is made with a single stone. This entire long structure is made with a single stone. Then there is a capital on above. There is an animal which is made. So it can be a bull, like Rampur bull capital is there, Sarnath lion capital is there. है ना? तो देयर इज दिस एनिमल जिसको कैपिटल बोला जाता था. देन देयर इज मोनोलिथिक रॉक दैट इज देयर. सो ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट इट इज अ वेरी टीडियस जॉब टू क्रिएट दीज काइंड ऑफ पिलर्स, एंड देयर इज नो टेक्नोलॉजी, देयर इज नो सीमेंट एक्सेट्रा, राइट? सो पिलर एडिक्ट्स दे वर लार्जली कन्फाइंड टू दिस गंगा प्लेन ओनली, एंड द रॉक एडिक्ट्स, बी इट माइनर रॉक एडिक्ट्स और मेजर रॉक एडिक्ट्स, दे वर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड थ्रू आउट द अशोकन एम्पायर. ठीक है, सो ये उल्टा किया हुआ है. बोथ द स्टेटमेंट्स आर इनकरेक्ट. माइनर मेजर रॉक एडिक्ट्स आर लिटिल इजियर टू मेक, पिलर एडिक्ट्स आर लिटिल मोर डिफिकल्ट टू मेक. सो दैट्स वाई दिस काइंड ऑफ डिस्क्रिपेंसी. एंड सम ऑफ द अशोकन एडिक्ट्स डिस्क्राइब, दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट, मेडिकल ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ ह्यूमंस एंड एनिमल्स. स्पेसिफिकली इफ आई वर टू टेल यू द मेजर रॉक एडिक्ट्स, द सेकेंड मेजर रॉक एडिक्ट, देर आर इन टोटल 14 मेजर रॉक एडिक्ट्स, एंड द सेकेंड मेजर रॉक एडिक्ट टॉक्स अबाउट द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ एनिमल्स एंड ह्यूमंस एंड यू नो मेडिकल ट्रीटमेंट्स. देन देर इज अनदर मेजर रॉक एडिक्ट कॉल्ड 13th रॉक एडिक्ट विच इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द कलिंगा वॉर. फाइन, सो हियर जस्ट सी, दीज आर सम ऑफ द एडिक्ट्स राइट दैट आर देयर. So they are the rock edicts, the minor and major rock edicts. So these are some major rock edicts. Dholi is there, Jogoda is there, Sanati, Yeragudi, Sopara. Then Girnar is there, Kandahar is there, Shahbazgari, Mansebra and Khalsi. Khalsi edict is also very important. ठीक है? So यहाँ पे एक broad idea रहना चाहिए. And pillar जो है, pillars are over here. पिलर्स आर कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड इन द गंगा वैली. नेक्स्ट, विद रेफरेंस टू अशोकन पिलर एडिक्ट्स, कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स. टू अशोकन पिलर एडिक्ट्स, वन फ्रॉम तोपारा एंड अदर वन फ्रॉम मेरठ, वर शिफ्टेड टू दिल्ली बाय मोहम्मद बिन तुगलक, एंड सम अशोकन पिलर्स आर विदाउट इंस्क्रिप्शंस. विच ऑफ द गिवन स्टेटमेंट्स आर करेक्ट? सो now we are on to the Ashokan pillars, and there were two pillars, one is from Topra and one is from Meerut. They were transferred to Delhi, but not by Mohammed bin Tughlaq. They were transferred by someone from Tughlaq dynasty only, but it was Firoz Shah Tughlaq. See, this is the Topra pillar, and this was transferred. This is Firoz Shah Kotla. If you have been to Delhi, this is Firoz Shah Kotla, of course created by Firoz Shah Tughlaq. And this particular pillar was placed here by Firoz Shah Tughlaq, not by Mohammed bin Tughlaq. So just remember, you will be able to memorize this. Agar aa gaya to, Firoz Shah Tughlaq was the one who brought the Topra pillar edict and installed it, and the Meerut pillar edict also. ठीक है? So ये हो गया. And so first is incorrect, and some Ashokan pillars are without inscriptions. Yes, sometimes there are no inscriptions, sometimes there are inscriptions which have faded away, right? Because itna time ho gaya, this is we are talking about before the birth of Jesus, right? So it has been a very long time. So here B only is the correct answer. Next, consider the following statements with reference to symbols and their meaning on Ashokan pillars. Symbols: lion, bull, elephant, horse. Meaning: represents the Buddha, symbol of fertility. Elephant represents the Buddha entering his mother's womb. एंड हॉर्स सिंबलाइजेस द सिद्धार्थ डिपार्चर फ्रॉम इज होम. सो हाउ मेनी आर करेक्टली मैच्ड? सो यू सी डेफिनेटली दीज कैपिटल्स, दीज एनिमल कैपिटल्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड रामपुरवा बुल कैपिटल इज देयर इन द पार्लियामेंट हाउस, राइट? दीज थिंग्स. सो बुल इज डेफिनेटली अ सिंबल ऑफ फर्टिलिटी. लायन रिप्रेजेंट्स द बुद्धा. एंड हाउ यू कैन रिमेंबर दिस? इफ यू रिमेंबर, हु वॉज द 24th तीर्थंकर? ही वॉज वर्धमान महावीर, द कंटेम्प्ररी ऑफ बुद्धा. इवन हिज सिंबल वॉज अ लायन ओनली, एंड द सिंबल ऑफ लायन रिप्रेजेंट्स द बुद्धा ओनली. सो बोथ द लायंस, वन हैज गिवन बर्थ टू बुद्धिज्म, वन हैज गिवन बर्थ टू जैनिज्म. वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. देन थर्ड, एलिफेंट. दिस इज अ वेरी फेमस साइट, दैट हाउ बुद्धा इज बींग कंसीव्ड बाय हिज मदर. एंड हॉर्स डज सिंबलाइज द सिद्धार्थ डिपार्चर फ्रॉम हिज होम. एंड वाई हैव बी रिटन सिद्धार्थ? बिकॉज ही एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम वॉज नॉट कॉल्ड बुद्धा. ठीक है. सो ही सैट ऑन हिज हॉर्स एंड ही लेफ्ट हिज होम. दैट इज द सिंबल ऑफ हॉर्स. सो हियर ऑल फोर आर करेक्टली मैच्ड. नेक्स्ट, कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट अबाउट अशोकन एडिक्ट्स. अलाहाबाद एडिक्ट्स मेंशन कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ सुदर्शन लेक ड्यूरिंग चंद्रगुप्त मौर्य रेन. निगाली सागर इंस्क्रिप्शन इन नेपाल रिकॉर्ड अशोकाज विजिट टू द साइट. रोमनदेई इंस्क्रिप्शन इन नेपाल रिकॉर्ड्स दैट द विलेज ऑफ लुम्बिनी वॉज एग्जेम्प्टेड फ्रॉम ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ टैक्सेस बाय अशोक. विच ऑफ द गिवन स्टेटमेंट्स आर करेक्ट? ओके, सो यहां पे जस्ट सी दैट आई नो आई टोल्ड यू दैट सुदर्शन लेक वॉज कंस्ट्रक्टेड ड्यूरिंग द चंद्रगुप्त मौर्य पीरियड, बट द मेंशन ऑफ सुदर्शन लेक इज नॉट मेंशन्ड इन अलाहाबाद एडिक्ट. ओके, सुदर्शन लेक्स मेंशन इज देयर इन गिरनार रॉक इंस्क्रिप्शन. गिरनार रॉक इंस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ रुद्रदामन, नॉट इवन ऑफ अशोक, ऑफ रुद्रदामन. एंड रुद्रदामन इज अ लेटर पोस्ट मौर्य. फाइन, ही इज अ शाका रूलर, वेस्टर्न क्षत्रप बोलते हैं. सो इट इज नॉट द अलाहाबाद प्रशस्ति, इट इज नॉट द अलाहाबाद एडिक्ट, इट इज एक्चुअली द गिरनार इंस्क्रिप्शन दैट टॉक्स अबाउट द सुदर्शन लेक एंड हाउ इट वॉज क्रिएटेड ड्यूरिंग चंद्रगुप्त मौर्य रेन, बट इट वॉज रिपेयर्ड बाय रुद्रदामन. ठीक है, सो फर्स्ट इज इनकरेक्ट. देन निगाली सागर इंस्क्रिप्शन रिकॉर्ड्स अशोकाज विजिट टू द साइट. यस, दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. निगाली सागर इंस्क्रिप्शन इज बेसिकली टू कमेमोरेट हाउ अशोका केम टू विजिट साइट्स रिलेटेड टू बुद्धा एंड हाउ द स्तूपा दैट वॉज इरेक्टेड ओवर देयर वॉज एनलार्ज्ड. ठीक है, सो सेकेंड इज करेक्ट. एंड रोमनदेई इंस्क्रिप्शन records that the village of Lumbini was exempted from all types of taxes by Ashoka. So all, again, we are applying that logic only, that all will never make you arrive at the correct answer. ठीक है, अशोका डिड गिव अ लॉट ऑफ विलेजेस, बट ओनली 1/8 ऑफ द भाग, 1/8 ऑफ द भाग वॉज टू बी गिवन बाय द रेजिडेंट्स ऑफ दिस विलेज ऑफ लुम्बिनी. वाई? बिकॉज लुम्बिनी वॉज द प्लेस वेयर बुद्धा वॉज बॉर्न. बट अशोका वॉज अ वेरी स्मार्ट पर्सन, राइट? सो ही वुड नॉट लेट गो ऑफ द रिवेन्यू, नॉट बिकॉज द रिवेन्यू वॉज अलॉट, बट बिकॉज अदर विलेजेस वुड ऑब्जेक्ट टू इट. सो ही वॉज अ वेरी गुड स्टेट्स मैन एंड दैट्स वाई ही सेड दैट ओके, यू डू नॉट गिव अस whole of it, you just give 1/8 of the bhag that is required from you. So all, again, 8 out of 10 rule, all will be incorrect. So here, one only is the correct answer. And regarding stupas, see, this is the Sudarshan Lake in Gujarat. Very beautiful, even today it is maintained very nicely. Regarding the stupas, there was a question in 2023 that stupas were not just created by Buddhists for the first time. Stupas are pre-Buddhist creations. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Pre-Buddhist creations have stupas and eventually they came to be associated with Buddhism. But aisa nahi hai ki before Buddhism, stupas were not being created. Stupas were being created even before Buddhism. Okay. So this is very important. This has been asked in your exam. So here, this is there, and now let's come to the last question. Considering the administrative units during Mauryan Empire, which among the following is correct? खरवातिक, द्रोणमुख, स्थानीय एंड समाग्रम. तो ये चार आपको चार वो दिए हैं. यू बिन गिवन फोर मेजर्स ऑफ लैंड, मेजर्स ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव यूनिट्स, एंड यू हैव टू अरेंज देम इन असेंडिंग टू डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर. सो हियर आंसर इज बी. समाग्रना जो है, समाग्रना वॉज अ मिक्सचर ऑफ अबाउट 10 विलेजेस. ठीक है, समाग्रना हैड 10 विलेजेस इन इट. देन खरवातिका, खरवातिका वुड हैव 200 विलेजेस इन इट. सो मेनी समाग्रनास वुड मेक वन खरवातिका. देन देयर विल बी द्रोणमुख, द्रोणमुख विल हैव 400 विलेजेस इन इट. सो टू खरवातिकाज विल मेक वन द्रोणमुख. एंड द लार्जेस्ट वुड बी स्थानीय. स्थान मीन्स प्लेस, राइट? सो अबाउट 800 विलेजेस वुड मेक वन स्थानीय. दैट मीन्स टू द्रोणमुख्स will create one sthaniya, and that is why I say that the administration of the Mauryas was very refined, very properly created, so that there is proper administrative, there's no administrative challenge. Spy system hai, pati vedak are there, then there are rajukas, and all these officials. So yes, that is the last question for this particular chapter. And as we have seen that UPSC is going towards the unconventional, so we have tried to include as many unconventional questions as possible. Beyond this, we would not like you to go also, because your brain memory will get fuzzled out. If you go too much into remembering these small things, you will miss out on remembering, economy, polity, modern history, geography, these things, you will miss out on them. And that is not something that is suggested. ठीक है? So just stick to the NCERT, stick to the PYQs and these questions, you will be good to go. No need to just, in a random test series, if you see a random fact, then don't be disheartened. Okay? It's not that you have to remember everything when it comes to the ancient medieval. Ancient medieval will be the part from which you will be leaving maximum questions, and that is what strategy says. Fine. So in the next class, we are going to talk about the post-Mauryas. This is a very, very confusing part where most of the people do not get who were the post-Mauryas, how many dynasties were there, and why do we classify them as post-Mauryas, and why not, pre-Guptas or anything. So important part hai. We will be covering all of it, and then we'll move to the Gupta dynasty. So that is there. And if you are enjoying these particular lectures, do let me know in the comments. And yes, all the very best. Keep revising, keep challenging yourself, keep revising everything, because revision is the key to this entire examination. All right. Thank you very much. I'll see you all in the next lecture. Bye-bye.